Hello and welcome to ReLearn. This is session number 9 of English Communication. And in this session, we are going to cover active voice, passive voice, and how to avoid passive voice. Now remember, we have been actually studying in all these sessions of English Communication about English grammar. We have already covered tenses, we have already covered verbs. Now we are going to practice active voice and passive voice. Now, active voice versus passive voice. What is active voice? In active voice, the subject performs the action. That is, of course, the subject. Could be a person, could be he, could be she, could be it, could be any particular thing that we are talking about. कोई भी चीज़ अगर कुछ काम कर रही है, action जो सीधा सीधा perform कर रहे हैं active voice में, उसे हम active voice कहते हैं. For example, Joseph draws a picture. Joseph is a subject here. Joseph draws a picture. It's a very simple sentence, and this sentence is of course set in or written in active voice. Now Joseph is a subject and he is doing something, that is drawing. Draw is a verb here. Now what is passive voice? Passive voice, the subject is acted upon. Okay, in the passive voice, the subject is acted upon. That means सब्जेक्ट बाद में आता है और जो चीज़ की है उसने वो पहले आ जाती है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द पिक्चर वॉज ड्रॉन बाय जोसेफ. तो सब्जेक्ट की जगह किसने ले ली है? द पिक्चर ने. एंड सब्जेक्ट कहाँ आया है? लास्ट में आ गया है. द पिक्चर वॉज ड्रॉन बाय जोसेफ. नाउ लेट अस सी, इन दिस केस द ड्रॉइंग इज द सब्जेक्ट एंड इट इज़ बीइंग एक्टेड अपॉन बाय जोसेफ. तो यहाँ पर जो ड्रॉइंग है वो सब्जेक्ट हो गई है. बल्कि पहले सेंटेंस में एक्टिव वॉइस में हमने क्या देखा था कि जोसेफ जो कि सब्जेक्ट है वो ड्रॉ कर रहा है, राइट? और हियर द ड्रॉइंग इज अ सब्जेक्ट एंड जोसेफ हैज बिकम एन ऑब्जेक्ट हियर. सो व्हेन टू यूज पैसिव वॉइस? यूज पैसिव वॉइस व्हेन यू डू नॉट विश टू एम्फसाइज द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस. जब आपको सब्जेक्ट के ऊपर ज़्यादा एम्फसाइज नहीं करना है, ज़्यादा स्ट्रेस आपको सब्जेक्ट पे नहीं देना है, बल्कि उस पर्टिकुलर एक्शन पे देना है जो सब्जेक्ट ने किया है. लाइक स्मोकिंग इज prohibited, right? So this is a passive sentence. Smoking is prohibited is a passive sentence. And another example is the management prohibits smoking. तो यहाँ पर क्या है कि management ने smoking को prohibit किया हुआ है. इसमें हम ज़्यादा stress किसको दे रहे हैं? management को. इसी sentence को अगर हमें passive में change करना होगा तो क्या हो जाएगा? Smoking is prohibited by the management. तो जो सब्जेक्ट है मैनेजमेंट वो लास्ट में आ गया है और यहाँ पर पैसिव वॉइस में सब्जेक्ट क्या बन गया है? स्मोकिंग इज प्रोहिबिटेड. सो द पैसिव सेंटेंस टेक्स अटेंशन अवे फ्रॉम मैनेजमेंट, सो दे डू नॉट हैव टू बी इन द रोल ऑफ बैड गाइज. नाउ दैट्स अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ ह्यूमर फॉर यू. नाउ लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद पैसिव वॉइस. ऑल्सो वी यूज पैसिव वॉइस व्हेन यू विश टू एम्फसाइज what happened and the person or thing acting is unknown or unimportant. For example, poisonous gases were found in 6 factories. The use of passive emphasizes the finding of gases, not who found them. इसके अंदर क्या आ रहा है? गैसेस तो फाउंड हुई, ये नहीं पता चला कि किसने फाइंड किया. सो पॉइजनस गैसेस वर फाउंड इन 6 फैक्ट्रीज. सो दैट मीन्स द यूज ऑफ पैसिव इज poisonous gases in the factories the poisonous gases were found in is active, and here we are using it just like passive. Now when do you use active voice? We have to similarly, in a way, when we are using passive voice, similarly we have to use active voice. Ab active voice hum wahan use karenge jahan par hame subject ke upar emphasize karna hai, subject ko zyada highlight karna hai, right? Use active voice unless you are required or have very specific reasons for doing otherwise. Active voice is generally leads to more concise writing. बहुत ही simple और बहुत ही concise, crisp writing होती है हमारी active voice के साथ. It clarifies who is performing the action. Remember, staying active is a healthy practice, especially in your writing. How to avoid passive voice? Now, many English verbs have been changed into useful nouns with the use of a suffix. Like announce का क्या हो गया? Announcement. Propose का हो गया proposal. Depart, departure. Meet, meeting. And if we are using all these words in active voice or in active sentences, we have to use the verbs instead of a noun to form these kind of words. Like the announcement was made by the judge. Okay, or he made the announcement. The announcement was made by him. इस तरह से हो जाएगा, right? Active में क्या होगा? They all departed together. Okay? Now passive में क्या हो जाएगा? The departure of them happened together. Or they all departed together को passive voice में आप इसी तरह से convert करेंगे. Meet का क्या हो गया? Meeting. Okay? इसी तरह से आप changing from passive to active voice. अब passive voice से active voice को change करना भी कोई बहुत ज़्यादा मुश्किल नहीं है, बहुत easy है. Another way of preserving active voice is by placing the noun or the nouns doing the action before the verb. अब simple है. Passive में अब आपको पता चल गया है कि जो verb होता है वो subject बन जाता है, right? और जो noun है वो क्या बन जाता है? वो last में आ जाता है. Okay, in place of a object, right? So here we are going to, if we are changing it from passive to active, we are going to first place the subject and then we have to place the rest of the object. The seeds were scattered by Jessica. A healthy harvest is expected by Jessica and her father. So answers are Jessica scattered the seeds and Jessica and her father expected a healthy harvest. Simple? Very simple. Now avoid the forms of verb to be. All passives consist of a form of a verb to be, that is am, is, are, was, were, been, plus a part, past participle. Example, the boy was impressed by Miss Jones. The boy was impressed by Miss Jones. Here, this is in active voice. The boy was impressed by Miss Jones. Now, a past participle is ed. ed आ गया लेकिन यहाँ पर, right? आप देख सकते हो. So, form of a regular verb for irregular verbs, en, n, and t, and can fill the empty slot in the sentence. You know, in the last sentence, there's an empty slot. I had dash it. So, how will we do it? We'll revise by avoiding to be verbs. Houses were destroyed by the storm. The storm destroyed the houses. Right? This is the active. This is the passive, and we'll change it into active. The cake was eaten by me. I ate the cake. Active. Active is what I am giving the sentence to you. Inexpensive ways of people to have fun are provided at the parks. This is active or passive? Inexpensive ways for people to have fun are provided by parks. The parks have provided the ways, the inexpensive ways for people to have fun. This is passive. Oxygen was discovered by 1774 by Joseph Priestley. So, Joseph Priestley discovered oxygen in the year 1774. A kitten was chosen by the family to have as a pet. Okay? So, these are the words which we can use and change into actives and passives. The storm destroyed houses, I ate the cake. These are the answers which I already told you. Joseph Priestley discovered oxygen in 1774. Parks provide inexpensive fun. And finally, the family chose a kitten as a pet. Now, active and passive voice. Simple present and simple past tenses. Active voice kis mein hoti hai? Simple present mein hoti hai. Okay? Like, how do people create ketchup? Ye question mein hai. We are discussing about questions. Active answer kya aega? People create ketchup from tomatoes. Right? Active question ka active answer hoga. Ab passive question ka passive answer hoga. Passive question kya hai? How is ketchup created by people? Ketchup kaise create hoti hai? Passive answer hai. Ketchup is created from tomatoes. Simple. So, people create ketchup from tomatoes and ketchup is created from tomatoes. Or, how chefs mayonnaise make answer from oil eggs? Okay. Simple present. Active question is, how do chefs make mayonnaise? So, active answer kya hoega? Chefs make mayonnaise from oil and eggs. Right? Active question, passive question kya hai? How is mayonnaise made? And passive answer kya ho jayega? Quickly guess. Mayonnaise is made by or from oil and eggs. Simple. Now, simple present tense mein. Active question, where do farmers grow grapes? The farmers grow grapes in California, right? Passive question hai, where are grapes grown by farmers? Passive answer would be grapes are grown in California. ऐसे ही आप simple present tense में भी कर सकते हो. Where do people find opals? People find opals in Tequila, Mexico. Passive में where are the opals found? The opals are found in Tequila, Mexico. Easy, isn't it? Similarly, ऐसे questions को आप practice कर सकते हो in simple present tense and of course in simple past tense also. Now, there are a lot of questions that you can go through and you can practice. When do Americans give heart-shaped candy? Americans give heart-shaped candy on Valentine's Day. So, when is heart-shaped candy given? This is the passive question. Passive answer is heart-shaped candy is given on the Valentine's Day. Now practice with the past tense. अब हम ये चीज़ें practice करेंगे past tense के साथ. The auxiliary verb for active voice changes from do, does to did. जो auxiliary verb होता है वो change होता है do, does से did पे change कर लेते हैं हम auxiliary verb को. So the auxiliary verb for passive voice changes from is are to was were. Let's see an example. Active question, when did they discover the world's largest diamond? World's largest diamond ko kab discover kiya tha? Active answer ho jayega, they discovered the world's largest diamond in 1905. Passive mein, when was the world's largest diamond discovered? The world's largest diamond was discovered in 1905. Toh jaise, jis voice mein question hai, usi voice mein aapka answer hona zaruri hai. Simple past tense mein, where did someone find the world's largest diamond? Someone found the world's largest diamond in South Africa. Passive mein kya ho jayega, where was the world's largest diamond found? Passive ka answer, the world's largest diamond was found in South Africa. Simple past tense, once again, why did the company grow cotton in Goodyear? The company grew. Again, remember, अगर हम past वाला verb ले रहे हैं तो हमको past verb ही use करना है. Change करके form. Grew cotton in Goodyear to make the tires. Similarly, you can practice all of these in the rest of the slides. You can see there are a lot of examples given to you. So you can just go through each example. You can read these examples and you can practice. And finally, here is something for you to do it yourself. Rewrite the following sentences by changing the nouns to verbs. Nouns ko verbs mein change karke aapko in sentences ko likhna hai. The two scientists could not arrive at a conclusion on anything. Remember, jab hum active se passive voice mein change karte hain, toh jo nouns hai wo verbs ban jate hain aur jo verbs hai wo nouns ban jate hain. The two scientists could not arrive at a conclusion on anything. That means you can change it, right? Yes, they held discussions on several topics, and however neither could put forth a proposal for a plan. And finally, another question is how to avoid passive voice. Ki avoid kaise karenge passive voice ko. Thank you, that's all we have for this session. Happy learning.